Welcome back. If you're a woman who styles her hair, which is pretty much all of you, then we've all been there. You want it to look good, you know how you want it, and in the process of getting it that way, you damage it. But there are things you can do to repair your hair and get it back into shape. And for more on that, we have Gemy CHIARIZIO, Studio 39 salon owner. Okay, you're here to help us out?
Absolutely.
911 for the hair.
Absolutely.
And you brought the main culprit for all of us. We need our straighteners, but then we, in the process of using them, we frizzle it and fry it and it...
You know, we see this
cracks.
In the salon a lot. It becomes kind of a vicious cycle. Women's hair gets damaged, and then they keep using the flat iron to smooth it out, causing more damage. So what people don't realize is that these irons were originally intended for salon use. So if they're going to use them at home, they really need to use a thermal protective spray and use it on a lower setting. It's really not for day-to-day use, those high settings.
But we all use them every day.
On the highest setting, yes. And those are really actually for in-home salon treatments. When we do keratin treatments and things like that, that's what that 400 setting's for. It's not for at-home use.
So why do they make them go to 400 when you can buy them in the stores?
Well, actually, it all started with Qi many years ago. It became so popular, and consumers loved it. So they just went mainstream, and from there, I mean, the rest is history.
The hair was ruined from there. Question for you, Gemy, and then we'll get on to your other products. When you flatten your hair and it goes and you see the smoke, is that the product steaming or is that you burning your hair?
Well, if you smell burnt hair, it's definitely your hair.
Right.
But a lot of the products do have moisturizers in them and panthenol. So when the heat hits it, it releases a steam. So that's not necessarily a bad thing.
Okay, speaking of heat, when you're drying your hair right out of the shower or the bath, there are do's and don'ts to when you dry your hair so that you don't do damage in the process.
You really want to tousle dry it very well before you start putting the dryer directly on the round brush. And we typically ask clients to just brush their hair and when they are round brushing it.
Now, is this the kind of brush you're supposed to use?
Yeah, this is actually just the wet brush that I carry in my purse because I have hair extensions. And for clients who have extensions, they do need to brush their hair more regularly.
When you dry it, though, with the hair dryer, can you use a round fuzzy brush or does that do damage?
You know, we really ask clients to get it about 80% dry so that most of the moisture is out of it.
With a rough dry?
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Just tousle dry it and then go in and do your round brushing. That's your thermal brushing. That puts the form into the hair before you do your finished styling.
Now, ponytails, scrunchies are not cool. So what do we use in our hair to put it back in a ponytail?
Well, okay, it depends on how much hair you have, obviously. But really, you remember those old school kind of goody elastics that had the big metal clip that attached them?
We're looking at a picture of one right now.
Right there.
Like a metal bar in there.
If you grew up in the 80s, you know that those things could do some lethal damage. Those are no-nos.
There's always hair attached to it when it's out of your hair.
Yes, it is like ripping it right out of your scalp. So you want to use the ones that actually, there's a small little seam where it's fused together, but there's nothing metal that will pull the hair from your scalp. That's huge. So if you have a fine hair, you can use those little plastic ones that are, they're quite small, like
those little tiny clips.
Yeah.
This next one will baffle dudes. When you tell a guy you don't wash your hair every day, they're like, ugh. But really, women with long hair are not supposed to wash their hair every day. We're supposed to only wash our hair two or three times a week. So does dry shampoo, though, does that dry out the rest of your hair?
Well, it does a little bit. I mean, what dry shampoo actually just freshens the hair. It has some fragrance to it. It absorbs some oil at the scalp, so your scalp doesn't look greasy. But you know, I have mixed emotions on the big trend that we've seen in shampooing less, because you really receive your conditioning benefits when you shampoo. However, if you're shampooing frequently, like daily, then you're stimulating the oil glands at the scalp and actually producing more oil. So I think the sweet spot for shampooing is really about, it depends on everybody's body chemistry, but about 2 to 3 times a week.
Question about brushing your hair, and this will be the last question. I love this, you're answering these rapid fire. We were always told growing up, you have to brush your hair 100 times a night to get it to grow.
That is so not true.
Bad news bears?
Very bad news bears. I mean, the main thing about brushing, and this is what, we do this little thing in the salon, where I'll ask them to brush their hair for me, and I'll go around the corner, and they're just like ripping their hair like this. I'm like,
So my hairdresser Lindsay calls it angry brushing.
Yeah,
so you're, it's you're like, doing it angrily.
Absolutely.
Why are you so angry?
So that's when we come around and I'm like, whoa, you know, before we start, let me just show you. This is how you brush your hair. You start at the bottom and you work your way up. So that way you're not like tearing the hair all the way from down here to the tip, and you're not gonna rip out any precious hair up here, which is what you're doing when you're brushing that way.
Okay. Gemy, thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Words to live by. Lisa, Rob.